Reincarnation, soul using another body as a medium. When you look into the Savane Hayat or the life and works of the Naqshbandi sheikhs, there have been examples when the souls that have been liberated, they have helped the present seekers in attaining higher levels of consciousness. And it is said that sometimes these current aspirants who happen to be the masters own right were helped by the past liberated masters. It always happened with all those who have experienced. They have such experiences with Moses too. The same thing happened. A voice descended upon him. In order for this voice to descend, some great divine spirit must use someone as a medium. But everyone cannot be used as a medium. This capacity and purity to become a vehicle, a medium, is not an ordinary thing. Communication can only be possible if a capable vehicle is available. You know, there are many things available in cyberspace. Even your own emails are there. But it becomes difficult for you to connect to those if you do not know the proper technique. We know because of the information technology, the things that were difficult to understand has become easy to explain. First of all, you have to have a proper understanding of the use of this technology. You must have the internet connections and know how to retrieve the information. Sometimes a minor mistake or hitch is making you difficult for you to understand. This we were aware of from times immemorial. Whenever someone goes into a deeper meditation, the consciousness is released from the body consciousness or the instruments of the body and mind. The sense organs are non-operative at that time. At that moment, a voice descends. You are connected with a higher soul. And communication happens. This is how it happened to Holy Prophet. It is a state of trance. But linguistically we say that he attained to Miraj. He went to the heaven bodily. Things like these. When the sage Vedavyas, who composed the Hindu scriptures, Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavad Puran and many others, he went into a trance meditative when he saw, he envisioned. This is how it always happens. It's not that their voice is speaking to you. A screen is open to you. You are seeing everything happening. And it is something like this: for a moment, a screen is opened in front of you, and it is removed. It is your memory that will remember what you have seen. So first day when it happened, Vedavyas saw something happening. He was in a state of trance, dazed, bemused what he saw. Sometimes it may be in words, sometimes it may be in the pictures, and then you have to give it a meaning. When he came out of that state of trance, he tried to write, but he forgot what he said, what he saw, what he heard. Second day again it happened in that way. Third day when it was to happen, he prayed, if this vision that is happening to me is so important, give me the capacity so I can present it for the generations to come. And then it happened, a scribe in the form of the elephant head god Ganesh was given to him. And he said, I am a fast writer. Anytime you will stop narrating. So Vedavyas sat with his eyes closed and he started speaking. And as he spoke, the scribe wrote, but his condition was that if you stop any time, I will leave and go. So sage agreed to that condition, but then he said, whatever I am speaking, you try to understand it and then write it. Narration of Bhagavad Gita began. The first verse, he used two words, dharma chetre kuru chetre samveta yuyusava. Mamaka Pandavaschev Kim Kurvat Sanjay. Dharma Chetra, the field of religion. Karma Chetra, the field of action. To explain one thing, he uses two words, the field of religion and field of action. Ganesh got confused in it, which is right. Sometimes these things are left, there will be two meanings in it. One will be understood, the linguistic meaning that will be understood by the ordinary human beings, and the deeper aspect of that is left for the awakened ones to understand it. The similar thing happened to Holy Prophet. And you recall that incident when he came out from that meditation with Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. As he came out, there was people who were involved in quarrels and matters relating to the world and wealth and things like that, ordinary mundane things. In that he forgot what he was told. When Abu Bakr asked him to narrate to him, he said he forgot completely. Then it is because of love for an innocent and devoted seeker and devotee, disciple of Holy Prophet, he had to explain. He said this Shab-e-Qadr that happens during the month of Ramadan, that night if you meditate, you will get the benefits 1,000 times more. So he said that it falls on odd nights after 23rd, 25th, 26th, 27th, 29th, any of these nights it may happen. But there is a symptom. The following day, this sun does not rise with rays. Although a condition is mentioned, but it is a post condition. The night has happened, and then you know. So it is through your awakening, through your understanding, you come to know that tonight is the night of Shavikadri. Not ordinary person can know that. But traditionally, in a ritualistic, we celebrate on a particular night as Shavikadri. So all these things are known. In the last century, the Theosophical Society, its head, Annie Besant and Leadbeater knew the promise that Buddha made that he will appear as Maitri. Maitri means friend. This will be his conscious birth, his light body, not the physical body. The physical body, the soul, enters through the realm of the body-mind. The body has to be created through the interaction of ovum and sperm. Then the soul will enter. But for light body, it does not need to assume the does not need the physical body. Physical body that comes into existence with the interaction of ovum and sperm. Any existing soul and who has attained to a certain level of meditative insights, purity of consciousness, it can descend onto that, the light body. Just as if your equipment is very efficient and highly developed, it can connect to any, and it is very powerful. It can connect to any sound vibration that is happening anywhere, from broadcasted from any television or the radio station. So the computers that are used in astronomy and space technology, they are of very highly evolved one. Annie Besant and Leadbeater knew about this. They decided to prepare someone on this earth to become a vehicle for Buddha's light body to descend. Buddha had said he will take one more birth with the name Maitri. A great deal of time eloped, 2500 years, but still Buddha did not take birth. Indications have been received that Maitri was not able to find a suitable womb or the vehicle to descend. Therefore, Theosophical Society made a different arrangement. If it was not possible to find a suitable mother or womb for it to descend, then some selected individual might be developed and made ready, through whom the Maitri could speak whenever he wanted to. For this purpose, theosophical movement began, and it was to arrange for the selection of a suitable individual and prepare him in every way to deserve to be the vehicle for the light body of Buddha. The soul which wanted to give a message through Muhammad found in Muhammad, Holy Prophet, a ready-made vehicle. He did not have to prepare anyone. Even the soul that gave a message through Moses did not have to make a vehicle. Even the soul that gave message through message of Krishna, and actually it happened, the Hindu scripture Ramayana and Bhagavad Gita were written long before they were actually enacted. It is like the story writer writes a story and keeps it in his cupboard, and then when he finds a suitable directory and producer, he hands over that story to him to be enacted on the screen. Valmiki had written the entire story of Ramayana, the story of Ram, long before it happened, and thereafter it was enacted. So even the soul that gave a message to Moses did not have to make a vehicle, because Moses was ready, Vedavyas was ready, Holy Prophet was ready to receive that message. That's why we call these as, Holy Prophet is known as Paigambar, the term that is used in Islamic tradition. In Hindu tradition, this word is used as avatar or incarnation, because then it becomes very easy. From the time you are born for that purpose, those times were simple. People were more innocent and less filled with ego. Not much work was to be done. It was easy to find a vehicle then, because one could, in full humility, surrenders one's body to another soul for use, as if the body did not belong to him. But in the modern day world, because of guilt, because of shame, because of many other, and ego and many other things, we consider this body is mine. And then it becomes difficult for you to be ready to become a vehicle. It happened with many of the Naqshbandi masters. They are in a state of meditation. They are attaining sincerity, and they found that at a particular point they are stuck. The souls, Hazrat Ibn Khalid Ghizwani radiallahu ta'ala anhu, his consciousness descended, and or that of Hazrat Baba Muhammad Samasani, helped the seekers. And it always happens. There is a similar incident, similar way, when you ask a master to pray, because pray for something. He is not having a child. You ask the master or the sheikh to pray. How will it happen? When you pray, you ask, you have come in your humility to ask an awakened one. He looks into He lends his energy to you. The body is yours, but the consciousness, the energy field is not yours. You are being used as a vehicle. He uses his both masculine and the feminine energy to lend you for something to happen. So it happened that theosophical movement started looking for finding a soul that could be prepared. They selected four persons: Jiddu Krishnamurti, his brother Nityanand. Afterwards, they selected Krishnamurti, and also there was a German, George Arundel. Nityanand died a premature death as a result of intensive preparation to make him the medium for Maitri. Krishnamurti became so mentally disturbed by the death of his brother that he himself could not become the medium. Krishnamurti was selected at the age of 9 by Annie Besant and Lee Beater. But this world is a big drama. This experiment was done by great powers. The drama was played on an international stage by powerful individuals. When the possibility of Maitri, Buddha's light body, entering into Krishnamurti became very close, certain soul of Devdutt, who was Buddha's cousin, who had for his whole life opposed Buddha and attempted several times to kill him, influenced the mind of Krishnamurti's father. Because when something has to happen, you are very close for this to happen, all of a sudden a negative force comes into you. It always happens. So Devdutt was Buddha's cousin. He was older than him, and he was always in competition, and each time he went into, he was defeated by Buddha. Subdued. Not that Buddha knowingly defeated him, because Devdutt was trying to compete with him with his impure mind, and that was not happening. So it happened that Krishnamurti's father, he filed a legal suit influenced by Devdutt against Annie Besant and other theosophists, demanding back the possession of his son Krishnamurti, who had been in their custody. They took over Krishnamurti, they started preparing him so that he can be ready to be the vehicle for the light body of Buddha. This suit was fought up to the Privy Council level. This fact has not been told before, but I am explaining that for the first time. Annie Besant fought the legal battle tooth and nail, but in the law courts it was not possible for her to win, because it was father's right to claim the possession of his minor child. Even if the child were to refuse to go to the father, it was not possible for him to win, because he was simply a minor. Therefore, it was necessary for them to run away from India. So Annie Besant and Leadbeater, they left India along with Krishnamurti with him. In India, this suit was going on, and Annie Besant ran away out of India, taking Krishnamurti with her. The suit went on up to the Supreme Court. There also Annie Besant was defeated. It was a legal battle, and Devdutt was much more powerful, and the souls become more powerful when they leave the body. When you are in the body, then the bodily inertia comes into play. But when it is not in the body, it becomes very powerful. Ordinarily, the law becomes more cooperative in the hands of bad men, because a good man is not preoccupied with matters of law. Bad man first makes all the necessary arrangement for his legal battle. Afterwards, Annie Besant appealed the case to the Privy Council in London, and there the decision was reversed against all legal provisions to let the child remain with Annie Besant. There had never been any such precedent before, nor was the judgment just and proper. But there was no further appeal beyond the Privy Council. Judgment was made possible by the influence of the soul of Maitri, who did not interfere in the lower courts earlier on. He reserved his powers of influence for the last court of appeal. When the matter was going on in the lower courts, it was Devdutt's influence that was working. When Annie Besant Carey took the case to the Privy Council, it is that time the light body of Buddha influenced. Thus, on the lower plane, it was an enacted drama witnessed by big headlines in the newspaper and a legal battle fought in the law court. But on the higher plane, a great battle was fought between two powerful souls. Afterwards, the great pain was taken in Krishnamurti's preparation that had perhaps never been taken before with any other individual. Individuals may have taken great pains in preparing themselves for certain achievements, but so many people had never staked so much for one single individual, but it happened because they all wanted the light body to descend, prepare someone for the descent of the light body of Buddha. In spite of all these great efforts, when the time came, all hopes fell through. It was in 1925. In presence of a large gathering of some 6,000 peoples in Holland from all over the world, and it was scheduled to announced that Krishnamurti had on that day given up his own personality and accepted that of Maitri. All the preparations was made. The long-awaited moment came when he was to climb up the podium, the rose podium, to announce that he was no more Krishnamurti, so that the soul of Maitri might enter and begin to speak. 6,000 delegates from all over the world had gathered together from far and wide in great expectation to listen to the voice of Maitri. It was a great unprecedented event ever to take place, but nothing happened. At that crucial moment, Krishnamurti refused to relinquish his individuality. You have to relinquish your individuality for a higher soul to descend into you. This is where, when someone makes a request for something to happen, there is a time gap. A sheikh waits for the single opportunity when your individuality is lost. Sometimes he messages, someone told you, the sheikh has did the prayer and this one's wish was fulfilled. So you decide, okay, let me try also. Tried many things, let me try this. But you are not ready to relinquish your individuality, that is most important. You have to become a vehicle for the energy to flow through you, the light body to flow through you. And that very moment something happens. So it happened at a crucial moment. Krishnamurti refused to relinquish his individuality. Devdutt had made his final attempt, and what could have been done, could not be done in Privy Council, was made possible in that last court of the delegates. He made Krishnamurti denounce that he was not a world teacher, that he had nothing to do with anyone's souls, that he was what he was and what he did not want to tell anyone else. A great experiment failed, but in one sense it was the first experiment of its type, and there was a greater possibility of failure. So it is not possible for souls to communicate unless they can enter into somebody's body. Buddha, Krishna, Shankar, when he was to experience what happens, what is the male-female relation, he saw a king was dying. Before his soul could leave, Shankar's soul entered the body. So the king's body, the soul was replaced with the soul of Shankar. And the king had died, but Shankar's soul came into, entered the body. So there was no question of individuality or ego. It experienced. But if you do not allow the consciousness of the master or the sheikh to, or the higher soul to work within you, the things will not happen. Firstly, it has to be a sincere effort on you, on the part of a seeker, that he wants this. In that humility you have made the request. And when you have to make the request, you have to become a vehicle for the energy field of the sheikh to work through you. And in that very moment, something happens. So it is not possible for souls to communicate unless they can enter into somebody's body. Until the consciousness can enter and take over your consciousness, even if it is for a moment, nothing can happen. And this is how Jesus was born out of an immaculate conception. The spirit of Holy Ghost completely entered into Joseph Mary was prepared. Her consciousness was not at the level of the body. To her, that act of male-female relation between Joseph and Mary was an act of meditation, because it was the consciousness of Holy Ghost that has overwhelmed, entered that of Joseph. He was ready. He surrendered. And the spirit of Holy Ghost entered that of Joseph. And in that case, the conception could be possible. And this is why we call the birth of Jesus out of Immaculate Conception. We call Mary as virgin, because there was no trace of being at the level of sex or the level of the body where you enter into relationship out of pleasure. Sex is for pleasure, but when you think of conception, it is not pleasure. It is you are working for the descent of a soul into the world. Higher the level of consciousness of an individual at that moment, the soul will enter into the body. The connection will be made. This is how, when Buddha was born, the experience of Maya Devi was as if a six-headed elephant, a white elephant, came over her body and disintegrated and dissolved. Ramakrishna's mother had this similar experience. The mother of Hazrat Ubaidullah Ahrar Razi Allah Ta'ala Unho experienced this similar thing. That is why a birth as a human being is indispensable. For example, someone dies now, and if he remains in a bodiless state for 100 years, there is no development of any type whatsoever during the 100 years. He will begin in the new birth from where he was when he died in the previous life, right from there. No matter how long the intervening period may be, the intervening period is not a time of development. It is like waking up in the same bed where you have slept in the previous night. That is why many religions went against sleep, because during the sleep there is no progress. These religions begin to reduce the sleeping time because of the lack of development that can happen during the sleep. You get up in the same bed you had slept in, unchanged, exactly the same way. When you take birth, again, you pick up from where you have left off when you died. It is the instrument of the body, the organs of perception and organs of action that help you to move, for the consciousness to move. But if the organs of action and perception is not there, because your body is the vehicle, if the vehicle is not there, you cannot move. The driver is there, but there is no vehicle for you to experience the driving. There is no change in your condition. It is like my stopping the watch now. But when I start it again, it will start exactly from where it had stopped. Thus, during the interval between birth, all developments cease or blocked. That is why the angels or gods do not reach or attain the state of salvation while they are in heaven. That possibility of growth or salvation is only given to the human beings because they have their body as a vehicle, the organs of action and perception. Whereas those angels or devatas, whatsoever you may call, there is no action there. One cannot do anything there. There one can only dream endlessly. For doing something, one has to assume the human birth on earth. Also in regard to soul recognizing each other, two spirits desiring to meet each other can do so only by entering into different bodies. There is no way of direct recognition. Soul, only when it enters into the body that it can recognize another soul. On the dumb bosom of this oblivious globe, although as unknown beings we seem to be born and live, there is a power within that knows beyond our knowings. It is like 20 people sleeping in a room. They will remain whole night in the same room, but in sleep there is no way for them to know one another. They can know one another only after waking up. When we wake up, our recognition continues. When you wake up, only then our recognition continues. As long as you are sleeping, the 20 people sleeping in the room, they will not recognize who they are. So in spiritual terms, when you attain the stage of awakening, only then you can recognize. But in sleep, it is not possible. There, we have no relation whatsoever. When you are sleeping, there is no relationship. Two people may be sleeping on the same bed, but there is no relationship. Relationship is possible only when you wake up and see if it is possible that one person may wake up and see all the others sleeping. This means that if one soul enters into somebody else's body, that soul can see other souls, but other souls cannot see that one soul that has entered. If one soul enters into somebody's body, it can know something about the other souls that are bodiless. But those bodiless souls cannot know anything. Let me explain this again. When you are in a bodiless state, the soul is in a bodiless state, it cannot know anything. For it to know, it must enter the body vehicle. You are sitting down, you may be speaking, but as long as the microphone is not there, your voice will not be amplified. So the moment the soul enters into another body, it can see the other souls. If one soul enters into somebody's body, it can know something about the other souls that are bodiless. An awakened one can know that. But those bodiless souls cannot know anything. Actually, the fact of knowing and recognizing is possible only through the body-mind mechanism, the brain residing in a body, and upon death, the body dies together with the brain. But there are some other possibilities. If some person have experienced while living and have established a relationship through telepathy or clairvoyance, which are the two methods of knowing without the use of the brain, and which have nothing to do with the brain, then such persons may succeed in establishing relationship with evil spirits as well as celestial souls. But there are very few people with that capacity. The information about the conditions prevailing in the spiritual world has been given only by such souls to us. Whatever information you have about the other world, the heaven and hell, the information that was given to Holy Prophet, to Vedavyas or Moses, is given by the higher souls, and we call them as God. I said, Holy Prophet and attained to Miraj. He went with his body in the company of, in presence of Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, and he used to have a communication. It is said like that. When the higher soul enters into you, it speaks, there is no dialogue. It speaks through you. It is your bodily instruments are used, and using your bodily instruments, it is the higher consciousness that is working. The situation is like this. If 10 people have taken a dose of alcohol and all become unconscious, but among them, one person might be there who has a habit of drinking and could remain fully conscious. And so he could tell about the experience of being drunk, while the others could not become, they become unconscious, and therefore they come, others could not, because they became unconscious before they come to know anything about it. As soon as they took the one peg, they become unconscious, whereas one among them whose capacity is much more, where it can happen. This is something very subtle, and it is not possible to explain into the words. Very rarely something like this is spoken.